Welcome to Wonder Soul, a weekly podcast series featuring a variety of topics dealing with life's many passions and experiences. Hello, everyone. I am your host, Bearded Buddha. This is episode 57, Failure, in which I'll be talking about a subject that not many people enjoy going over, but it's super important in life and in achieving any goals. But I hope you all enjoy, and don't forget to stay tuned after the episode for ways to connect and support Wonder Soul. So, without any further delay, welcome to episode 57 of Wonder Soul, Failure.
I love this one. Fail early, fail often, fail forward. You know, it's always a little bit frustrating to me when people have a negative relationship with failure. Failure is a massive part of being able to be successful. You have to get comfortable with failure. You have to actually seek failure. Failure is where all of the lessons are. You know, when you go to the gym and you work out, you're actually seeking failure. You want to take your muscles to the point where you get to failure, because that's where the adaptation is. That's where growth is. Successful people fail a lot. They fail a whole lot more than they succeed, but they extract the lessons from the failure, and they use that, the energy, and they use the wisdom to come around to the next phase of success. You gotta take a shot. You have to live at the edge of your capabilities. You gotta live where you're almost certain you're gonna fail. That's the reason for practice. Practice is controlled failure. You're getting to your limit, getting to your limit, getting to your limit. You can't lift that, you can't do that, until you get to the point that all of a sudden your body makes the adjustment, and then you can do it. Failure actually helps you to recognize the areas where you need to evolve. So fail early, fail often, fail forward.
Failure sucks so much. I think we can all agree to that. I think there's no reason to even debate the amount of pain, the amount of embarrassment, and just overall the shitty feeling that failure can leave on you when it does happen. I could waste really this whole episode telling you the amount of times that I've failed, fucked up, made mistakes, did things that I regret, things that I wish I could take back. If given the second chance in life, how I would do things differently. But that'd be a waste of an episode and really wouldn't get the message across that I want to in this episode about failure. See, in our culture, I think today, I think failure is something that's very looked down upon. It's something that we like to shame ourselves and others whenever it does take place. But we forget to realize just how important and necessary failure is, especially to achieving goals. And we also forget that failures and setbacks, they're going to happen. No matter how far ahead you plan, no matter how much you take into consideration, there's always going to be things that will happen that are usually out of your control. Or it'll just be flat out your fault for why you failed. Not situations or factors out of your control, not anybody else, not location, nothing, no other things and no other factors except for you, because you've got to remember that you and I were not perfect. And as much as we wish we could be, and I'm sure we have our strengths, but our weaknesses are still very much there. And no matter how much that we work on them and try to improve them, there are always going to be days, times where we fuck up and we end up failing. It could be a test. It could be something that you've been working on for a long time. Maybe it's something that you try for the first time. And most of the time, whenever you're going to attempt something for the first time, you're going to suck at it. You're going to mess up, and technically you're going to fail at it. But it's really just how you deal with that failure and how you deal with that adversity that determines if you will be able to achieve the goals you want the most. I mean, I know people get very tired of hearing, you know, keep positive, think positive. But, you know, positive thinking is, it's more used so that you can grow and learn and eventually evolve from what we experience in life. Because if you take failure and let it really just hold you back and determine who you are as a person, and you let it just be the last taste in your mouth and you give up, then it's going to be really hard for you to rebound and redeem yourself. And I think that's where positive thinking does come into play, because you're able to at least look at it from different perspectives and maybe even allow yourself to pull yourself out of that negative, dark pit that you've found yourself sitting in. Because, well, like we just said, failure sucks. It's just not fun. But you, I, anybody who's trying to do anything in life, and it doesn't even have to be like a huge goal, just everyday life, you're gonna fail, and we're gonna reach these moments of setbacks. And you and I both need to accept that failure is just part of the process, that it's just part of life, that there's nobody that gets to live out this experience unscathed and without any mistakes. And that because of that, you have to develop ways to handle failure. And one of those is really not to avoid failure. I've heard many people, especially successful people, who mention that in a lot of ways you need to seek out failure. That when you do fail, if you know how to build up your tolerance for failure and you know how to handle your character and yourself after such an event happens or takes place, that you'll be able to become stronger and better because of it. Because failure really shows us what we need to work on in life. What are the areas that we are actually weak in? And how to reapproach a problem. Because obviously, the way that you did before in that attempt did not work out. So it's frustrating, but you also have to know how to deal with the frustrations and stress and those negative feelings like guilt and embarrassment. You need to learn how to deal with those. Vent, go for a walk, work out, do whatever you can to take your mind out of that gutter and allow yourself to kind of get rid of all of that shame. Because the only shame that should stay with you is if you don't try again. And if you let a setback or failure just knock you out of the game. And I know that I felt that this month was a good time to mention failure as a topic here on Wondersoul, because like I've mentioned at the beginning of the month, you know, it's a time for new beginnings. It's a new year. A lot of people were wanting to do new goals and set out to accomplish their New Year's resolutions and so much like that, that if you haven't already, you probably will fail and mess up in that process of trying to achieve whatever you set out to achieve at the beginning of this year, or even before then, or even when you attempt and go after whatever it is that you're thinking about going after, just know that it won't be this flawless, easy ride to the top. It's just not how it works. And I feel that how you deal with that is so important, and how you view it and how you look at it and how you let it affect you is also so important. Because when you're dealing with a feeling like failure, it like I said, it can be frustrating. I have found that what works for me is maybe listening to some music, talking to a friend or family member, and venting, writing, going for a walk, doing something that's going to take my mind off of the situation at that moment, allow myself to get rid of any negative and built up aggression, and just clear my head. Because if you make decisions after you fail at something, then you're probably going to be filled with a lot of emotions, and you might not be thinking clearly, and you might make choices that even add to how bad a situation is already, you know. Just because something bad happened doesn't mean that you should pile all that with more bad choices or bad decisions, or just things that could negatively affect you, right? So it's important to know how to deal with that frustration of failure before going any further. I think that that's really vital, because a lot of people don't know how to deal with anger and frustration, a lot of negative emotions, sadness, heartbreak, which a lot of these things can be threaded and connected to the concept of failure. But it's also important that in doing so, after you deal with that frustration, that you accept that failure is part of the process, because it is. If success is part of the process, then failure must be somewhere in there. And it may happen more times than the success that you're looking for. And part of like dealing with all that and looking to make a way so that you can readdress and come back to whatever you're looking to achieve, you have to be brutally honest with yourself. You have to look in the mirror and look inside at yourself and go, what did I do wrong? What do I need to do differently? What about me is the reason why this didn't work? Before we look at anything else, any other factors, any other people, any other situations, or anything, you know, it's very important that you develop this ability to accept responsibility for everything that happens in your life, good and bad, because it allows you to move forward with this sense of control. I think that if you start just blaming other people and situations for why things don't work out in your life, or why something didn't happen the way you wanted it, then you're gonna constantly feel like you're out of control, that you're just playing a game where you have no control over the rules and what direction you're going. And it can really build up and make it hard to even want to attempt again, because you feel like it's just not in your favor. And you know, honestly, a lot of the things that are worth going after have a high failure possibility. I mean, the percentage that you're gonna fail is usually what outweighs the percentage of you being successful, especially with a lot of things that we view as being really worth it. And you have to develop the habit of knowing how to deal with failure. Because in a lot of ways, failure, when we have those moments, it tests like how bad we actually want to achieve the set goals. Because in a day and age of instant gratification, where things really come a lot easier to us than ever in history, when something really, really worth it and attractive in our eyes, is something that we want, is usually packaged with, I guess, a lot of struggles, a lot of obstacles, and a lot of chances that you're going to fuck up along the way. And more than likely, you may not get what you're looking for or what you're working for. And when we come across setbacks or events that, you know, are like kind of roadblocks, it really allows you to examine, how bad do I want this? Like, how really bad do I want to achieve this goal? And then it also shows us what we do wrong. I mean, it's a learning experience overall. You know, the only mistake is not learning from a mistake, because that's how you gain wisdom in life, is that through these experiences, good and bad, you're able to see what you need to improve on and what you're doing right and what you're doing wrong. You develop this ability to learn and adapt from life experiences, not like in any other field. As far as like something maybe competitive or challenging, something like that, where you learn how to adapt to the game plan or what's going on and you can change like your approach, you need to take that and put it inside of this philosophy when it comes to just life experiences and life goals. And just accepting that nothing worthwhile will come easy. Nothing. If it was easy, then everybody would do it. And that's something I've always heard so often in life, is that the things that people truly want out of life are not easy. And they're a lot harder than the things that, you know, just come natural for most people or just are easier to obtain. You know, it means that we do live in a time of instant gratification. People want results fast, and people want to go through things flawless and without any problems and mistakes. And I understand that. I mean, I'm part of that group as well, especially when we have this access to so much information. You can start to think to yourself that there really should be no reason why I mess up, because I have all the information I need to do this correctly the first time and one time only. But that's not going to be the case. Even with knowing as much as you could know, there's nothing more valuable than knowing and learning through experiences and learning from your mistakes and learning from setbacks and failures overall. Because that's really what ends up making you the person that you are going to be or who you are. It's really not when you succeed. Look at people how they react to difficulties and how they overcome obstacles in life, where for most people, maybe they would throw in the towel and just say, fuck it, this ain't for me. And it's not about how people accept awards, it's about how people accept coming in second or last place and what they do after those events take place. I think that you can come to this like fork in the road, and it's really up to you. Do you take the path where this charges you up, you're more motivated, you're allowing yourself to work even harder now because you feel like whatever you did up to that point wasn't enough? Because obviously you didn't get what you were looking for and what you were working for. So now you have to approach it differently. With any problem, in any problem in life, if you don't get the results you're looking for, you did not do something right, or you didn't do enough of something. You can't expect to go about it the same way and expect to just keep repeating yourself, because you're going to get the same repetition of results as well. So there you go. It's common sense, but really we can lose sight of that, especially when it's like our own personal lives. And there's going to be a lot of people that are going to become naysayers, you know, and they're going to be out there when you fail, and that's going to suck. You're going to have to learn how to tune that out. And if not other people, especially your own inner voice, you know, where that self-doubt can really take over. And there's plenty of examples in my life where I've let that inner voice of mine really take over and talk me down and make me feel low and worthless and like shit because I failed at something or I didn't achieve something or I made mistakes and now there were consequences to those mistakes and I didn't like those. And I mean, one of the reasons why I got out of the Army is because I failed the physical fitness test. And that was a tough pill to swallow. And, you know, that led me to be a civilian again. I'm out on my own. And, you know, I've failed classes in school before. I failed geometry and I had to retake it. Man, there's just a lot of different things. There's different tests, different times where I just failed to do what was necessary or failed to do what I thought was right. And a lot of the times I beat myself up because of it, you know? And even though there were voices and I was lucky to have these people around me to kind of talk me up and try to get me out of that dark place that you can find yourself hanging out in, you know, but not everybody has that. And unless you can pull yourself out of those situations and pull your own head out of the gutter, then you're going to find yourself feeling even worse than you did when you initially failed whatever it was that you failed. Because it's so easy to talk down on yourself, no matter how confident or cocky or whatever type of person that you are. You can't ignore results, and when the results are not the ones that you were working for and looking for, then you can't ignore those very long, and you start to accept responsibility. But then you also don't need to go so hard on yourself where you're not able to get back up. Be honest with yourself. Know where your fault is in this whole situation and then readdress it and go about it differently. Because it's just too easy. It's too easy to listen to other people doubt you and talk bad about how you messed up and how you didn't do what you said you were going to do. And you're all talk, no action. You know, oh, so-and-so always says they're going to do this and they always talk a good game, but they never back it up. Don't let yourself gain that reputation. It's not fun. I mean, it's just showing you that, yes, you're going to fail, but it's how you deal with failure. Because I've watched, and I myself in moments of my life have let failure negatively just really pound me into the ground. And I've seen where people have entered depressions, where people have taken their life. People have done things that they can't take back because of a failure that has taken place in their life and their reaction to it, how they go about dealing with it, is really the true success or failure. You can fail at how you react to failing. And that's where the real failure is. Now, don't let that scare you. I mean, please don't let that scare you. And that's where a really interesting quote from an author that you probably all know, even if you hadn't read her books or not, but the award-winning author J.K. Rowling, she talks about how she embraces failure. And I think this is very important that we all kind of learn from this example. She has a quote where she says, "It is impossible to live without failing at something. Unless you live so cautiously that you might as well have not lived at all, in which case you fail by default." And that's so important because a lot of people don't like that feeling and that taste of failure. Nobody does. We can all agree to that, right? But some people, and I've had examples in my own life, I'm sure you can think of some in your own as well, that because of those failures and their impact and the weight of them, they've almost paralyzed you into trying other things or trying again because you're afraid. You become afraid of failing again. And so you don't try. You stay in this small bubble, which you like to call your comfort zone, where things are, you know, pretty reliable, pretty normal routine. They usually go about, you know, the same way every day, so you don't really have to worry about things going wrong. Maybe every time you do, it starts to freak you out because you start thinking about how shitty a feeling it is to fail and make mistakes and to not get the results you're looking for. But like that quote by J.K. Rowling, where you basically fail by default when you don't try. When you let failure fan the flames of fear, and therefore you're unable to make progress. You regress, you degress, you go backwards, and you just kind of curl up in a ball and just kind of go through life staying in a lane that you are comfortable with. Whether it's good for you or bad for you, you know, that's to each their own. But it just makes sense that you wouldn't let fear of failure stop you. You have to face that fear. And even if it's by developing little things that you can build up that confidence again, there's got to be some kind of method that you need to approach where you're able to bounce back and try other things. It's just like what Michael Jordan said. He has a quote where he says, "I can accept failure. Everyone fails at something, but I can't accept not trying." And I always like to think about that. Like, I think of highly successful people. Most of the time, they're the ones who have failed the most. And even though us as a culture and society really focus on their achievements and what they have done right, and all the accolades that they have and the trophies and all the things that they're known for that are so good and we admire them for, we do not ever really focus in on what they did wrong. The amount of times that things did not work out, where they did fail, where they were on the verge of quitting and giving up, but they did not. And that's very key into anything in life. It is just a theme that I've tried to hold on to, especially when like the going gets tough, is that no matter how dark and how gritty and sad and angry and everything that your life can become in moments, you have to find the light at the end of the tunnel, and you cannot give up, because when you give up, that's when you truly fail. And then when you don't even try again in any category, in anything, that's when you fail even more. That's a lifelong failure. That's not even just a moment. That is lifelong. And, you know, I get it. Like, we live in a world where we're afraid to fail. It was taught to us as kids, you know, that being wrong and making mistakes are bad. And of course, that makes some sense when you're teaching a kid to not do A and B, because A is going to get you hurt, you know, and so you're trying to develop those skills and just those that knowledge that any human being or anybody needs to know to like really live life without making like obvious stupid mistakes. But our minds, they use these painful memories of the past to provoke negative emotions like fear and anxiety. And it stops us from making those same errors, like anxiety, like our brains in us overthinking situations. Not only is fear at hand, but you also have that feeling of just overthinking a situation, so you talk yourself out of even attempting to do anything about it, you know? And so you don't try no more. And that's why my advice to you is, if you failed at your New Year's resolution, you failed at any goal, if you're dealing with failure right now, maybe a failing relationship, maybe a failing investment of some sort, that you don't stay in that place very long, that you adapt, you learn, and you try again. Because Samuel Beckett has a quote that goes like, "Ever tried, ever failed, no matter, try again, fail again, fail better." And that's where this whole theme that I've really attached myself to of fail forward, that it's so important that we don't avoid failure, that we actually look for failure and try to learn from it. I mean obviously it can go about different ways, but hopefully you get what I'm saying when it mean like looking for failure. Because it's usually the things that you know that you could fail at that are the things that you should be focusing on improving. I mean, it's all about the learning experience. Life is one huge learning experience, and your ability to change and adapt and to face fears and to step out of your comfort zone and to improve in areas that you're weak in. You have strengths, everybody does, but usually our weaknesses can be the reason why we don't accomplish certain things. And if you don't listen to constructive criticism, if you don't have the ability to be brutally honest with yourself and look inside and see why you failed, is it certain habits that you have, certain bad habits that keep grounding you and holding you back and slowing you down? Where is it in what you were doing? Did you go wrong? Why did you fail? Did you not study enough? Did you not prepare enough? You know, what was the reasoning that you can discover and research that you think that you failed at whatever it is that you attempted to do? Was it a diet that you were attempting and you went like a month, but then, you know, just kind of fell apart? Well, why did it fall apart? What was the trigger? What was the reasoning? Why were you weak on that day when the diet started to fall apart? In so many examples in all phases and areas of life, you can always find what was your part to play in that. And also what you can do differently, because whatever you did wrong, you can do right. But you have to learn from that, and you have to know what it is that you did wrong, because how are you supposed to do something right? Like correct your wrongs if you're not sure what it was in the first place that you did wrong. And then, like, if you're vulnerable in that, then you might listen to the naysayers. There's going to be people that are going to tell you false information. And you're going to give into that because you're kind of confused and lost and you're not really sure. Like, maybe it was because I did this, but really it had nothing to do with that. So it's all about knowing yourself and knowing what abilities you do have and the things that you need to work on. But knowing that no matter what happens, whenever you go after a goal or just in life in general, that things are going to happen that you're not going to enjoy. You're not going to be 100% supportive of, you know, as far as like nobody wants to fail. Nobody does. It's just common knowledge. Everybody is trying to be successful in life. Not everybody's trying to be failures in life. But in order to get to the successful, we have to go through the failures. And there's no path, I think, in life where you avoid the failures. And even if you somehow miraculously find this shortcut and you're able to like dodge and weave and juke out of any kind of upset, setbacks, mistakes or failures, and you do achieve success, you don't know how long that will stay in that state of being, because you will eventually have things that happen. Like, you know, we've had examples in the past. The stock market has crashed. You might have been someone who invested and did everything right, but there's always going to be an event that no matter what is going to come out of left field, and you're going to have to know how to deal with that. If you have been avoiding failure and avoiding just how to deal with these upsets in life, then whenever adversity reaches you and shows up on your doorstep, you're not going to know what to do. See, failing makes us stronger. And that's why we are able to eventually reach success, because your novice, beginner version of yourself is not strong enough to get to that successful point that you're looking to reach. You're not going to go to the gym and work out and hit all your goals, drop all your weight, lift the amount of weight that you want to lift in that first go. It's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. You might even hurt yourself. So then you're going to have to learn from making the mistake of maybe trying a little too hard and taking on a little too much, that, okay, now I need to kind of draw this back. I need to approach it differently. Maybe I don't need to go so hard. I need to give myself a break. Maybe I need to you know, learn how to do this better and more, you know, and be more correct in my form and so many other things. There's always something that you can learn from. People who play video games, you know, like if you're playing a game and you're wanting to get better at it and you keep losing, you keep getting beat, obviously you need to look at what you're doing wrong and then just kind of take note and go, okay, I need to work on this. I need to work on my blocking. I need to work on not like doing this when, you know, this situation pops up. And then if you really focus on that, you'll see improvement. You'll see higher success rates. I mean, it just makes more sense to think that you don't try to solve the problem with the same thinking that causes the problem, because then you're going to just see the same results. And I think it's just so important that we really remind ourselves that there's so many successful people out there that they're not perfect, flawless human beings. And you must understand that, and you have to believe that, because if you don't, you're going to separate the possibilities of you becoming successful, and you're going to separate the idea that it's even possible to do what they do. You could do it better. You can learn from their successes and their failures, especially their failures, and see what you can do to improve. And that's also something that I want you guys to understand, that when you do see somebody on TV or read about them on the internet or whatever, these people that are just like highly admired and people that have maybe a lot of money, a lot of success, or whatever, however you view success, there was a time where they were faced with basically, I want to quit situations in life. They were faced with so many struggles, so many upsets, so many ups and downs, so many mistakes that, you know, unfortunately we all have to kind of go through. It's a learning curve of life. It's like just growing as people. You have to deal with learning what hurts you so you don't get hurt again. And that's just it. That's with relationships. They say, you know, date so you know what you want in a partner and what you don't like, you know, what habits and what personality traits are like something that you are attracted to and look into somebody else. You know, there's just by experiencing things, by trying things. And that's really the key to this, is that you're going to fail. Accept that. And if you have a goal right now and you're not doing enough or not seeing the results, you know, be honest with yourself, but also give yourself the benefit of the doubt that maybe, you know, you're expecting certain results too fast and you need to give it a little bit more time. But you also just need to not give up, and you got to keep trying. And even when you face a roadblock, a dead end, that you need to bounce back and keep trying, only if you truly want it. Because I feel like that's really what it comes down to. How you spend your time, how you spend your life, how you react to adversity and all these situations in life, that it seems like the deck is stacked against you. And you shouldn't prevail. You should not come out on top. It's those people that truly reach happiness in life and fulfillment and success. Because they're able to take the highs and the lows, and they're able to adapt. And they're able to not give up, because it's so easily. When you fail at something, it's so easy to just take that as a sign that maybe I'm not good enough at this. Maybe I shouldn't do this. Maybe this just isn't for me. And sometimes, you know, honestly, that might be true. But I mean, if it's really something that you're dead set on accomplishing, then you need to keep it in your mind that no matter what life is throwing at you, no matter what you're doing, you need to always feel like you can improve, and you can always bounce back, and you can never, ever give up. And that if you don't try, then you've already failed. You know, they always say, like, you miss every shot, all the shots that you don't actually attempt. That makes sense, right? And I always think about how people really want to just step up to the plate, and every time they're at bat, hit home runs. You're not. You're going to strike out. You're going to only get like singles, doubles. You know, there's just going to be so many different varied results. But every time you go up to bat, you're going to improve. You're going to learn and you're going to adapt. You're going to take those experiences and you're going to take those and internalize them and bring them into more of a positive result, because you're actually learning. You know, they learning from mistakes, learning from failures is so important. I've had so many different setbacks in my life, and I'm sure that you have as well. And we're all different, we're all the same in so many different ways. But you know, there's been moments in my life where I just wanted to say fuck it, and you know, throw in the towel. And especially if it was something that required a lot of dedication, a lot of hard work, maybe something that required a lot of patience. You need patience. Things are gonna take time. Those things that truly are worth it will take time. That body and mind that you want is going to take time. You're not going to see it in like a couple days. You're not going to see the results you're looking for in a couple days. So, I mean, this is just for life in general. But I mean, if you're a creator, if you're someone who's trying to accomplish a lot of things in life and you're motivated, don't give up. And if you fail, that's okay. You're going to fail a lot. And it's going to justify the feeling of success, that redeeming quality that happens when you are climbing a mountain and you slip and you fall and you got to start over. Maybe you even get like almost to the top, like right there, like you can almost reach out and grab it. And then you slip and you tumble down, you go crashing down. Because they always say, like, as quickly as you can rise is as quickly as you can fall. And that's so true. And I feel like it's just a process that you need to trust in. That failures are not something that you should really think badly upon. And you should actually not try to avoid them so much. I feel like people try to just do things so flawlessly. And then it builds up anxiety and this really unrealistic pressure and expectations on you, your results and your life. And as much as you want to have these awesome, great, big things in your life and achievements, a friend of mine the other night just was mentioning that, you know, just small things, small changes, small adaptations are what lead up and build up to make the big things. And it's really just those small details about how you can improve. I think that we all need to improve in something, and we're all trying to. And we need people around us to keep us honest and keep us true. And when we do fail, to lift us up, but also tell us like, hey, maybe if you didn't stay up so late, then you wouldn't, you know, wake up late and, you know, show up late to work, or show up late for that test, or miss that opportunity, that job interview, because maybe you decided to go hang out with friends the night before and your priorities were all fucked up. Then it just kind of like, you'll be able to document your own like path to why something didn't work out. And if you have people around you that can also help out with that, that you can trust and you feel that are honest and they have nothing but good intentions and want to see you succeed, that's so important. And it's even more important when you don't have that many people or even anybody at all. You need to do that all on your own. Not everybody comes equipped with this very supportive family or friends. And then especially when everybody is getting older and everybody's doing different things, they may not understand why you want to do what you want to do. They may not have the same goals as you, and they may not be able to really get behind why you want to do what you want to do. And so therefore you need to carry yourself along that journey and that path. And especially when you trip and fuck up, and people are going to go then, oh, see what I tell you, you shouldn't have done that. That was kind of a stupid idea, right? And that's where you got to go like, no, it's cool. Hey, you know, use failure and setbacks as motivation. You know, anytime you've been rejected, it's good for you. It builds that tough skin, and you're able to become stronger because of these unfortunate events that take place in life. Failing classes, failing tests, failing anything. You know, it actually has more of a positive result and effect if you choose to accept it for what it is and learn from it. Because if you don't, then it is that shitty, sucky feeling that we all know and hate. But it also lasts a lot longer than it should. And, you know, unfortunately for some of us, it can be lifelong. When you quit, you know, when things get tough, it's not, I'm sure that when time goes by and years go by, you'll be like, I would have traded, you know, the pain of what I feel now for not trying and the regret of quitting and giving up for whatever I was going through at the moment that made me feel like I should give up or I want to give up. Because, you know, it's true. There's plenty of things that I've started and quit. And later down the road, after thought and, you know, thinking about it, I really, really regretted it. And it felt bad. It felt worse than whatever I was going through that actually pushed me or allowed push me over the edge of just throwing in the towel. So I'm just trying to give you guys some encouragement. I know a lot of people, especially this time of year, they just have a lot of expectations for themselves, setting a lot of goals. And I'm just wanting to be at least one voice that tells you, hey, it's okay if you fucked up, as long as you learn from it, as long as you try to improve from it. And it's okay if you failed whatever goal you've already set for yourself. Who says you have to shelf it and you never have to attempt it again or try it again? Who says that failure or that mistake is what's going to define you? I mean, who says that you can't ever attempt anything else than what you already know? I'll tell you who says that, and it's the only person that you should listen to, and it's yourself. And you can't allow yourself to talk like that. You can't allow yourself to think like that. And you have to block out any voices, anybody who is telling you otherwise. Because then I think, truly, they aren't the people that really want to see you succeed. And you are in control of that. You have more control and power over what happens in your life than you like to give yourself credit for. And you're the only one that will ever get in your own way. And if you fuck up, you fucked up. Learn from it and move forward. And it's just like how Will Smith was saying, you know, you fail often, fail early, fail forward. And it's so true. Because that's the only way you're going to get better. And you will get better, but you just can't give up. And I just hope that no matter what goals you have set out for yourself this year, or just in life, you know, overall, that you are able to achieve them. And I wish you nothing but the best of luck. And I hope that you don't encounter too many mistakes and failures, but just know that they are going to happen. And that the sooner that you develop the ability to accept that failure is part of the process, you figure out a way to let out your frustrations and you're able to be honest with yourself and just do what is necessary to achieve those goals, then you'll be a happier and better person. You'll be a healthier person and you'll be thankful that no matter what, you didn't choose to give in and give up. Thank you once again for listening to this episode of Wonder Soul. I hope you got something out of it and enjoyed it as well. And if you did enjoy this episode or the podcast overall, I hope that you can take time to share these episodes with friends and family to help Wonder Soul grow. Another way to support the podcast is by rating and reviewing on iTunes or wherever you listen to podcasts currently and subscribing to the podcast so you will automatically get new episodes whenever they are released. If you decide to subscribe to the podcast, why not go ahead and subscribe to the Wonder Soul YouTube channel if you haven't already? It is a great platform to connect and to receive not only podcast episodes, but live stream and gameplay highlights either from our live streams here on the YouTube channel or on our Twitch channel, Wonder Streams. There you can like and comment on episodes and videos and be in tune when we release YouTube-only content in the future. I love hearing back from you guys and your thoughts and opinions on the episodes and all the content that Wondersoul puts out. One of the best ways to connect with Wondersoul is on social media. So you can follow us on Twitter and Instagram. Simply search Wondersoul and then you'll be up to date on new episodes and anything new coming from Wondersoul. I want this podcast, Wondersoul, to be a platform in which we can connect and discuss our interests and passions. So thank you again for listening. And until next time, I will talk to you guys later.